Okay, next we are going to Canada to see the medical mission there. You can see our master from the abode went to Canada to visit the medical center. The deputy CEO Zhong told the master said on the counter it is antivirus actually. Yeah. And the this table is actually portable. So when we go out to do the clinic, we can just carry it. Yeah, less than 300 pounds. And Masters gave the scholarship to the Humber College. And this is the deputy, the school deputy. It's really touching that when we see the medical mission in Canada, in traditional Chinese medicine, is a very special characteristic in Canada. We went to the all different places to do the free clinic of TCM, traditional Chinese medicine. The free clinic is just the way the short clip we just saw. And also they went to a remote Aboriginal area for those Aboriginal residents. You can see that his hand is cannot raise. Now he can rest high above the head. And the old lady was not able to see, but after acupuncture, she was able to see clearly. Every Wednesday, they went to the island to have a free clinic. So we can see that they have already scheduled regular visiting there.
So
we have many Chinese medicine doctors join our team.
Let's
take a look now. Call out our deputy director of Canada. Deputy said, as a doctor, we need to go out, not just waiting there for people to come. So we go to every places to do the free clinic. Now we will do the call out to Canada. Medical mission direct, deputy director. Brother Zhong, thank you. We like to be together with you because you have a positive energy. What time are you there now in Canada? Can you tell us? Now it's 5:30 in the afternoon. So thank you. We don't have a problem for jet lag. Can you share your slide? Deputy Director can speak very well about the mission in Canada. Okay, you can begin.
Okay, 可以的.
Dear brothers and sisters around the world, I am so honored to be here to share the medical mission of Canada here with you. Shiji started from 1992. One brother brought the seed to Canada. For the last 30 years, we have step by step keep doing the job, establishing the medical mission. So now we have already established the Zhengzhe clinic for TCM. And we also helped the local hospitals to raise the fund to buy the equipment for the COVID and all the medical equipment. And now we restart after the COVID our mission to put Chinese medicine medicine to the hospital to help the local hospitals. So we will see from the beginning. So I will start from the beginning. From 2011, we started the free clinic in the Vancouver downtown for the Taiwan Cultural Festival. You can see this is on the downtown street of Vancouver. Each time there are 10-20 Chinese medicine doctors went there to help the patient. You can see all the volunteers and all the doctors and nurses together. So the next year, we have the TIMA Canada set up. Right now, we have invited more than 250 doctors to join our TIMA team. Even 12 of them have already certified as our commissioner. And this is the ceremony of white coat ceremony. So, and they have become our staff. 2013, we have a symposium, started the symposium. 2013 is the first symposium for the TCM symposium. And many doctors from other countries also come to join us too. So we can see in different years, every year we have a symposium. So our doctors in this area in Canada has become stronger and stronger. After 2019, because of COVID, so we have stopped the symposium. On 2014, we expand our service to the First Nation, which is the Aboriginal residents. This is the starting point, which is the Aboriginal Single Mother Center. So we can see the doctor is actually a lady to help the service the single mothers there.
从那之后啊，一步又一步的。
So we have more and more Aboriginal sites set up to help all the First Nation communities. Many doctors go to all these communities for these Aboriginal people.
因为在上个世纪末，很多的华工从
last century, we actually have many overseas Chinese came to Canada to help build the railroad，然后呢就进入到原住民部落里去跟他们。And they stay there, so we have some overseas Chinese people there too，很多加拿大的原住民，including the Aboriginals。曾经都是我们中国人，所以难怪我们跟他们。So all the doctors feel because they are overseas Chinese, they feel very warm. Now we have more than 10 sites there for the Aboriginal already. And this Seabird Island is 2 hours away from Vancouver. We still go there to do the service. 2015, we have collaborated with the local hospital to provide our Chinese medicine service. This is the first hospital, Bernabe Foundation, that we send our doctors into their hospital to do the Chinese medicine and the acupuncture service. Because of this, here in 2016, we have a big surprise. The 30-year-old International College of TCM Vancouver formally donated to Zhengzhe and become a member of the Zhengzhe Canada Medical Mission, which is a surprise to everyone. So we are so happy. So the school now have already cultivated more than 1,000 students. Now after they join us, we wish that all the Chinese medicine doctors can have a better connection with us around the world.
到了2017年，我们跟公立医院的合作再进一步。
Starting from 2017, we have an on-site long-term care.
2018年特殊的因缘,
and 2018, we collaborate with the university, which is the Humber College. And we have also the training facility and all the equipment there to do the research. So this kind of cooperation brings Zhengzhe more opportunity to serve for the community. And in our anniversary, we were trying to prepare the vegetarian dinner. So the school of Humber College, they have a beverage and food department. So we can see the chef is called Chef Shalab. Sure, shut up is very interesting in making the dinner with us. So our culinary team went to the school to share with the great chef. So they put together with even a trial meal to try all the dishes to make a perfect banquet, you know. Yeah. So we can see that they spend a lot of effort to prepare each meal, each dish. And on the day, actually, the delivery is done by the doctors to help to the meal on each table. We can see such a beautiful dumpling, actually, rice dumpling. We are so happy that to have that this. Thank you. Step by step, starting from 2011 all the way to today. Yeah, our best wish is to help all the patients to relieve their suffering. Mandela said it always seemed impossible until it's done. So we have this great opportunity to serve the local community, and we also want to follow the vision of Master so we can fly together. Thank you everyone. Thank you so much. Dr. Zhong.
我们的中医师啊，中医师麻烦您回去把曼德勒他写的这一句英文。
Can you read this sentence for us?
标准太多的，来。是。好的，他是说
It always seems impossible until it is done.
对，就是。Truly,
we just need to do it. Before we finish it, it always seems impossible.
就向前哈。 所以我们也请我们的中医师把你的简报收掉，然后帅帅的就是在画面上哈，在这边呢，我们的今天要导读的苏玉豪呢，他就讲说，做好事不能少我一人。
Somebody have a good feedback already said that we need to do it together for all the medical mission, not just the doctors.
人文医疗以人为本,
Thank you, such a gentleman, Dr. Zhong. You can spread our Chinese medicine culture in Canada. Thank you so much. For the last 10 years, you have already dedicated so much effort. So we are very grateful that you have done so much in Canada. Another sister comment on her way to Taipei.
北京的慈金说，加拿大的学姐已经开始了，看到了中医师，就想到加拿大的慈济医疗之夜，是在艰辛中成长。Let's
give a big applause to Dr. Zhong.
一并掌声再次。Thank
you.
我们的中医师，谢谢。他这一段时间一定觉得我非常的繁琐，因为我一直在追资料，然后他在墨尔本非常的忙哈。Thank
you for providing us such a good slide and data.
谢谢你们，谢谢。 好，拜拜。那我们往下进行哈。谢谢大家对我的关怀。内蒙的恩利说，看见美云老师的好像有点虚弱。Sister
said, "Teacher Mayin seems a little bit weak. Of course, the voice is different from last time because of the COVID.
周三云端又相聚，家人个个都发喜。美云老师精气足，哎，这所以感觉。
But I feel you are still okay.
恩利觉得。